Alright, so lastly we saw how to create a basic HTML form using basic HTML elements, form elements. But in this video, we are going to learn about HTML5 form elements. And we are going to learn the new form elements that have been introduced that make our form look much much better and much easier to use. And is very user friendly. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so now we know that we have to write all of the content inside a form tag. So we'll open up a form tag. And we'll close off this form tag at the end. Okay, we closed it off here. Now we know the two attributes that are needed. The first is action attribute. We'll leave it empty because we don't have a server right now. And the second one is method attribute, and we'll give it a post value. Okay, so now first thing we want is we want to input a name. Okay, so we know how to do that, right? Input tag, input, then we use type attribute, that is text. Then we'll give it a name, let's call it first name, and we'll close off this input tag. Now for I want two more blocks like this for middle name and last name, so I'll just copy this and I'll paste this two times. I'll just change this to middle name, and this to last name. Alright, and I'll add two line break tags, so that's proper structuring. Now the next thing I want from the user is email. I want to enter his email from him. So now there's a slight bit of additional feature you can do in HTML5. Let me just show you. You open up the input tag. Now the normal type attribute value you choose is text. But if you want to accept email from the user, there's an option called as email. Just click on this. Okay, you'll choose this email option. Now let's give it a name. We'll call it email. I'll tell you what it does at the end when the form is ready to use. We'll close off this tag. We'll add two line break tags. Now we want to accept phone number. So now again, input type, and this type, instead of using text, we are going to use something called as number. You can see there's number option here. We'll select this number option. Okay, again we'll give it name. We'll call it phone number. And we'll close off this tag. Again, two line break tags for proper structuring. And we'll just copy paste this because we want the same thing with our age tag. Let's just paste it here. Okay. And for gender, we're going to create a drop down menu. We did it last time also. So the syntax for drop down menu is select. We don't need a class, so we'll remove this class part. We'll give it a name. Gender. Okay, now the option one we're going to have is, then we're going to have one more option and one more. We're going to have four options, right? We'll give them values later. Let me just create four options. Okay, now this will be 0, this one will be 1, this will be second, this will be third. Now here I want select your gender. Alright, now here I want male as my first option. Second one I want is female, and let's call the third one others. Okay, now this is our drop down menu, and after this select tag I'll give out two line break tags. Okay, so this was our personal information section, right? Let's look it up in our browser. Let's see how it looks. We load it. Let me just save it. I forgot to save this. If you don't save it, you can't see it in your browser. Okay, now you can see personal information section looks much better than the address section. I even forgot to give it a title, so we'll just give it a title. We'll call it HTML5 form elements. Now we'll structure our address section. Now for address, we want only one thing, so I'll just copy this out. We are going to use type as text. We're not going to change our type, so I'll just paste it out. We'll change the name. That's the only thing we want to change. Okay, and this address type we are going to use in drop down menu, so I'll just copy this out and I'll paste it here. And here I'm going to change select your address type. or we'll just call it select address type, so it's visible to the user. Okay, we'll change it here, residential, and we'll add one more option, that is commercial here, and we'll remove this third option. Save it, and I'll change the name here. It is house name, society, locality. You can give any name, okay? So it doesn't matter what I'm giving. You can give your own name, you can give it short codes, whatever you like, but don't let it be same, always change it. Okay, so now it's pretty much done. We'll just add BR tags here. And after landmark, we won't add BR tags because I want to show you something. Okay, and we'll add BR tag after state. Now we'll save it and we'll open it up in our browser. Refresh. Continue. Okay, so now you can see that landmark, city and state is in one line. It's better like this, okay? You don't want a form to be too big or too long. It's better this way. Okay, so now you can see that it's all much better than first when you saw it. But still, user can't understand that this is a different section, that this all is a personal information section and this is a address section. So we'll make it much more easier for the user. We'll just add a submit button here. Okay, at the end of the form, before ending the form, we'll add a submit button. Input, and the type will be submit, and we'll give it a value submit and save it. So you can see submit button has been added now. Okay, so now we want to structure, we want to create a block of personal information and a block of address information so that user can easily verify, user can easily understand what it is. So the element that we're going to talk about is called as field set. It is an HTML5 element. So what do we do is we want a block here, right? So after this form tag, in this personal information section, I'll add a tag called as field set. Field set tag. Okay, and I'll close this tag at the end of my personal information section. I'll close this off here. Okay, you can see I closed it off. I'll save it. You can see a block has been created here. Okay, I'll add a BR tag here. A block has been created here and it is different than it was, okay? And now again we'll add a field set tag here in this address section. We'll add a field set tag and we'll close this field set tag at the end of our address part. We'll close it off here. Okay, and we'll add a BR tag. We'll save it. Okay, there was a spelling mistake. Just a second. Okay, so now it has been closed. Now let's open it up in our browser. Refresh. Okay, so now two blocks have been created. It's much better right now. Yes? Now, I want something like a caption to our this block that says personal information here, and I want address information here so that user can read it and enter the information accordingly. Now what we'll do is we'll add one more element that is new in HTML5 and it's called legend tag. So we'll add it after our field set tag. It goes like this, legend, and you close this off right here right now, and inside this legend, inside this tag, I'll write personal information. I'll save it. Now you can see that this personal information caption has been appeared here. By using this legend tag, we put a caption to our section, this section, personal information section. And the same thing we're going to do, we'll just copy this and we'll add it after the field set tag, and we'll change this address information. We'll save it. Let's check it out in our browser. Now you can see that personal information and address information has appeared. Now this is much better than the previous time we saw it, without field set, without this block, without this caption. This is much better, right? Now the next thing that we're going to learn is called as a placeholder tag. You might have seen that when you open up a website, when you register for it, you can see that there's a suggestion that you have to enter your first name here, then you have to enter your middle name, then you have to enter your last name, and then the email, it says please enter your valid email ID. So how do we do that? How do we give our users a clue? Because our user doesn't know, there's three blocks. So what do we have to enter here? So let's see a placeholder tag. Let's go into the first input. We'll see placeholder. And we'll, I want my first name here, right? So I'll say first name. You can see that this has appeared here. Okay. This is what placeholder does. It gives our user a clue that what we have to enter here. And it is pretty much different from value. You know what value duck does is, right? It, whatever we write inside value is been written up here. So we have to delete it before typing. But placeholder just tells us that we have to enter our first name here. This is like a clue given to us. Now I'll just copy this. I'll paste it off. This is an attribute to input tag, right? I'll paste it in every input tag. I want there to be a suggestion in every input tag. So I'll just place it off in every input tag. Sorry, I'll just have to change to age here. I forgot to do that. Okay. Now you can see first name. So I have to change it, right? So I'll change it to middle name, last name. Then this is email, right? So instead of this, I'll write enter valid email. Okay. And again for the same thing for the phone number, so I'll write enter valid phone number. Okay. And here I'll write enter valid age. And for gender tag, we don't need one because you can already see select your gender here. Now for address also, I need this. Do I need this? So let's just check it out. What's the harm in checking it out? So we'll add placeholder tag here and we'll call it house name. Copy it. Sorry, we'll copy the whole thing so we don't have to type it out again and again. It saves time. We'll paste it off in all input tags and then we'll just keep on changing the names. And again, we won't need it in address type because we already have select address type here. Now this is, it was house, this is society, this is locality, then we have landmark, then we have city, the last one is, sorry, the second last one is state. And that's it, right? We don't have a placeholder in this address type, so we'll just remove it. I added one by mistakenly here. Okay, so we'll save it and now let's see how it looks in a browser. Let's just refresh it. So now you can see it is much better. You have clues that you have to enter first name, your middle name, your last name, enter valid email, enter valid phone number, enter valid age, your gender, your house. Now the next tag that we're going to see is called as the required tag. So when you go to a form and when you fill out a field and by mistakenly, if you leave a field out, suppose I entered this and I left this email ID part and I moved on to phone number. So it shows an error while submitting that this field is required. Right now, if you see, I'll just write this one thing and I'll click on submit. So my form will be submitted. There's no error. Okay, that does not say this all of these other information is required, but we need it, right? How do we do that? So again, we'll go into every input tag and we'll add an attribute that is called as required. Okay, and this attribute does not require any value. Okay, you just write it. There's no need to give it any value. So we'll add it to every input tag. Okay. we'll add it, we'll paste it to every input tag, even the gender part and the address type part. Even though it is a drop down, it is required, right? Again, we'll go here and we'll paste it again here. Okay. Now I'll just show you what it does. After I save it, we'll open it in a browser and check it out. Okay, so now I've put required in every part. Now let's save it. Let's go to a browser. We'll check it out. Refresh. Continue. Now I'll just write S here and try to submit it. Now you can see this field is required. So I'll write S again and I'll write S here also. Let's see if it works. You can see this field is required. Now I'll input an invalid email ID. So you can see that because we use this email type here, you can see that browser shows us an error. Okay, when I click on submit, browser will show an error. Please include an @ in the email address. So we'll add an @ here. Please enter following part after @. You can see that once we have entered email type, it will, until we completely enter a valid email ID, it won't work. Okay, so now still it won't work because we don't have a .com.in. Okay, we need a .com. Okay, so now valid phone number. So this time, let me just show you this in Atom. Okay, it will be much better if you can see side by side. Okay, so now I'll enter S and S here. And you saw the what email does is, right? So I'll just input xyz@gmail.com. And in this part, you can see we use the type called as number. Okay, so other than numbers, I cannot enter any letter. I'm trying to enter, but I can't. And when I enter numbers, then only you can see this number. Same goes for age also. We have also used the type number here. Okay, so until and unless it's number that we're going to input, it won't accept anything else. Okay, because if sometimes you enter a wrong keyword, so it will just prompt you that this is wrong and it won't take your input, right? Now select a gender, we'll select a gender. Now again house number. Now this is plain text, right? We haven't used any of the special things here. This is just plain text, so we can enter text here. So we'll just enter one word and we'll leave out one word empty. We'll leave out one or two blocks empty and let's see what happens. I've also left out this, so let's see if it prompts us. Yes, it prompts us. Please fill this field out. Again, I'll fill this. Let's submit. Did we forget? No, yeah, so this field is also required. So we'll select residential here and we'll click on submit. So we'll just save it now again and open it up in a browser and we fill it. We'll refresh it here. Okay, so now xyz email ID xyz@gmail.com. okay, all of these is required and all of these won't work until you fill every bit of information. Something will enter, ages, something will enter, we'll select our gender, something xyz. Not going to enter it. Okay, so I'm just showing you this, right? And we'll submit. So a form will be submitted without any error. Okay, now the next thing that we going to see is called as autofocus tag. What an autofocus tag does is as soon as you open up your form, it will point out to this page. It will point to any tag that you've put autofocus in. Now let me just show you. I'll put autofocus right here. Okay, and I'll save it. Let's open it up in a browser. Now you can see that nothing is happening, but as soon as I refresh it, you can see that this blank and it's already blinking. So it tells the browser that you have to go to this, you have to start from here. So this is what autofocus tag does is, and it also does not require a value. Now if I remove autofocus from here, I'll just cut it, Control X, and I'll put it in this this age part. Let's put it after this required tag. I'll save it. Let's open it up in a browser. Continue. You can see that age is blinking now. Okay, so it tells the user that this has to start from here, but we don't have to, right? We have to start from the name first. So again, We have put out of focus here. We'll save it. Okay, so we saw field set that created this block. This two blocks is created using field set. Then we saw this legend tag that created address information or personal information. Then we saw this placeholder that gives the user a clue. Then we saw required tag that tells the user that all of these fields are required. And now we saw autofocus. Now the tag we are going to see is called as a label tag. Label tag. What it does is, now you can see on your screen that you have this name, email, phone number and all of this. And there's nothing, you have not added a paragraph tag, nothing. So what you do is, before your name, you open up a tag called as label. Okay. And after your name, you close off that tag. Okay. Now we'll do the same thing. Copy. Paste. We'll change it later on. Don't you worry. I'll show you the change. Let's just add label tag first. Okay, here we have email. The next thing we have is phone number, right? Then we have age and gender. Again, here we'll add labels. Okay, so label, label, we'll close this label tag here. Okay, and we'll add it to all of them. Let's just copy, we'll paste it here, near to every block that we want our label to, right? We don't want them to be empty. Paste it here. So now we'll just change this. Here we add society name. Then here we had locality. Here we had landmark, city, then state, and then the address type. Okay, and we'll just save this now. We've added label to every one of them. We'll open it up in a browser. We've saved it. Let's refresh. Now you can see that we've added label to all of them. There's no change. Is there? Yes, there's change, right? There's proper spacing. You can see it looks much better as we have used label. And if we hadn't used label, there was improper spacing. And now this proper alignment, these two words are properly aligned. Suppose I hadn't used label before every one of them, then that would have been an error. If you input something here, that it wasn't, the alignment of these two lines weren't proper. But as soon as you use label, the alignment is proper. You can see that it looks much better now. The alignment is much better and it looks much better than before. Okay, so this was label tag. So you should always add this label tag also. Now we saw everything. We saw field set, we saw placeholder, it tells our helps or instruction to fill data. We saw autofocus attributes, attribute by placing it in a tag, the page focuses on it. So starts from here and no input value required. Okay, we just write required tag and autofocus tag. They do not require an input value. Okay, we just have to write them. And then what we saw. Okay, so this was it. Now we are going to see a few things. Other than this, we are going to see all of the values that are present in this type attribute. We saw text, we saw email, we saw number, and we saw many more in the last video. Checkbox, radio, and etc. Drop down all of them. Now we are going to see a few more of them. Okay, I'll just do it before the submit button. I'll just show you what all we have, much more inside this. Now we saw text, we saw checkbox, we saw radio. The next thing we're going to see is called as password. So field input open type, here we're going to select is password. So you guys enter passwords, right? So when you enter a password, that password should not be visible. Only dot should appear here. If we use text, let me just use text and I'll show you what. If I enter my name, my own name, you can see that I can see that it is visible. It is visible to me. But as soon as I use password as my type, I'll write my own name again. And instead of my name, you can see these dots have appeared. So it's great if you want to use password, right? If you want to get information, you want username and password. So it is great to use it when you want to take a password from the user. The next thing that we, let's add a placeholder here. So you guys can, when you pause the video, you'll know what we have done, right? So we used a placeholder tag here. Again, what we want to use, second one, this field is required, right? So we'll use required and we'll save it. Now, the next thing we saw was numbers. We saw how to use type as number here in the age and phone number section. Now the next thing we'll see is, okay, let me just add number here. Okay, now the next thing we're going to see is called as a range. Let me just show you again. Input type will be range. Okay, and you can see that this has appeared here. This is our range. We can select it from 1 to 10. Now to write this range tag, the best way will be you write 1 here and you write 10 here. Now you can see you have to select from a range of 1 to 10. You can also give it one more. We can use attributes. The value will be 1 by default. Okay, and minimum, you can see min has appeared here. Min will be 1 and max will be, we have max here, max will be 10. So it can't go other than this. You understand this range, right? Why did we write 1 to 10? I'll just remove this 1. I'll remove this 10 again. We wrote this 1 to 10 to understand what the range goes from. So again, we'll write 10 and we'll write 1. So where have you seen this? You guys might have seen this on Amazon or Flipkart when you want to select from your price range. Okay, when you want to select from 100, 200, 500, 2000 or 1 lakh or whatever. So there you have seen this range tag. Okay, you have seen this range type, right? And what did we do? We added a value that it starts from 1 and minimum will be 1, maximum will be 10. We added these two more attributes to this range tag. Okay, so this was about range. Now the next thing we're going to see is called as date. Sometimes when you're booking an appointment at a doctor, or you're booking something and you want to select the date when you want to arrive, or suppose you're registering for an exam and you're filling out the exam form and you want to select the date, there's a calendar that appears, right? So we just select date. You can see that now a date has appeared here. You can either fill out this date or you can also select it. You see a calendar has appeared here. You can just select the year, you can select the month, you can select whatever you want. You can just move backward. You can go to July. You can just select this today's date. Okay, and you can just move like this also. This is what days does. Now we'll just give it a name. I'm just leaving it out empty because you guys know, right, what we have to do here. We just have to fill this out, right? I'm just showing the important part. Okay, so now the next thing we're going to see is the type time. Okay, suppose you want to enter the time. Sorry, this not the time we want. Okay, now you can see time has appeared here. You can select your time 23 23, that is 11:23, or you can again select it from here. You can change it up and down. Okay, so this is time type. Now the next type is color. If you want to input color, again you have seen this on Amazon, the color you want, you select the color from it. So again, input type will be color. And you can see that black colors appeared here, but as soon as you click on it, this color palette appears. You can select all the colors you want from it, and you can click on OK, and this color will be selected. So there's pretty much many more options. I'll just show you how many options our input type attribute has. Okay, so we saw button, we saw checkbox, we saw color, we saw date time. We saw date time local, we saw email, this file, there's hidden, there's image, there's month, number, password, radio, range, reset, search, submit. There's many options here. You can try them all out by yourself, but these were the basic types that I showed you. So this was it for this video. I'll see you guys in the next video.